I was sitting in a K-5 class, and there was a table with only girls, and they were trying to build a tower to help Jack to reach the magic beans or something. And their tower toppled, it fell. And one of the girls started crying. And then another girl, 5 year old, just tapped her on her shoulder and said, "We don't cry, we're engineers." And then I myself almost started tearing, like, oh my gosh, the seed is there. They're thinking like an engineer. It's like, it's okay to fail. Things don't work the first time, we'll fix it. And another girl on the table was like, "I told you guys we needed to make a wider base and blah." And just the vocabulary they were using, I was like blown away. It's like, this is gonna work, this is great. It's a great idea, we have to pursue it, we have to invest, we have to make our best effort to keep this going.
Project Lead the Way reminded me what I was passionate about. I love teaching kids. I love seeing that light bulb turn on, and I love when they love learning. In my career, I'd been teaching third grade for a long time, and I felt like we were losing that. And I'd gotten to a point where I was ready to give up teaching. I didn't have a passion for it anymore. When I got to start teaching Project Lead the Way and I saw their little light bulbs turning on and they were excited and they were high-fiving each other in my classroom, and I remembered what I loved about teaching because of this curriculum.
Project Lead the Way has changed the way I teach, the way I think about teaching, the way I ask questions, the way I attack problems, the way that I try to get discussions moving. And I think that a large chunk of what PLTW does is not just give the kids the ideas and to be creative, be innovative, but also it helps the teachers, it empowers the teachers.
I'm learning new things, my kids are learning new things, they're excited about it. So everything is new, everything's fresh, what's happening out there in the real world today. Not last week, not last year, today. They know that when they come in my classroom, it's going to be different. It's not going to be sit in a chair, get out the pen and paper and do something. They're going to be up. They're going to be talking. They're going to be walking around the classroom. They're going to be working in teams. They're going to be building things. They're going to be taking things apart or destroying things. That excites me because I can see them excited.
Being a Project Lead the Way teacher has just brought a ton of energy to the classroom because of that hands-on aspect. You know, we bring in a new curriculum from Project Lead the Way, like the CSIM one, and it sort of reinvigorates me in the classroom as a teacher. And I think the kids sort of feed off that energy too. So as they see that, and they see that I'm excited to teach this, then it gets them more excited for that curriculum too.
It's the experiences with the students, the look on their face, the enjoyment, the humor, the laughter, but the learning that's also going on with all of that. They enjoy it. And them seeing all the hard work that they put into it work in the end, yeah, that's something that they're gonna take with them and remember for the rest of their lives.
I really do feel like Project Lead the Way has been a catalyst for change for different ethnicities, different groups, and in terms of bridging those gaps and exposing students to different careers, just really showing them what's out there. The curriculum is very relatable to students and students of every background. And so I do feel like PLTW has been this catalyst for changing the way science and engineering and math all looks like in the classroom for every background of student.
Students that might not have found a place and space in school, all of a sudden things and activities make sense. Opportunities to work in a team and maybe recognize somebody else's skills at the same time recognizing your own skill. And we always talk about the benefits to students, but I see similar things happening with teachers. I see teachers who all of a sudden are teaching in a different way with a new pedagogy and a facilitated classroom, and they think about how that connects to the other content that they're teaching. So I think we've got an opportunity to impact youth and set them on their path for what's next, but at the same time impacting educators as well.
Project Lead the Way really helped me see how K-12 education could be tied to the real world and careers, and always having the idea of careers present in students' minds, but not just you're gonna grow up and be something or someone someday, but like, what do you want to do? How can we apply that in a way that's good for you, your family? You can actually make money, and that's good for society at the same time. It's about making a really good impact on the world.
My hope is that in the next 25 years, Project Lead the Way continues to grow. And it's no longer a question about if a kid is going to have the chance to have this curriculum in front of them. My hope is that Project Lead the Way finds a way to be in every classroom.
There's growth yet ahead in terms of rural students, urban students, every child having the opportunity to really have a solid root and foundation in what science, technology, engineering, and math could open their doors in terms of possibility of a career. And bottom line, that enables economic advancement of families. So there's a lot of growth yet ahead, and I'm very excited for the future of Project Lead the Way.